How many times have you set New Year's resolutions? How many times have you set a goal that you didn't accomplish? What's going on, homies and homettes? It's Elon here, and I'm not going to waste any of your time. So step one, finding your goals. Goal setting is a skill that people don't give much thought to. Normally, people generalize and they rarely make it a priority. So in this case, let's take it a step back and actually brainstorm about what you want to accomplish this year. And make sure you get very specific with it. Example, I will lose 80 pounds this year. See how clear that was? Not I want to lose some weight, not I want to eat healthier or I want to exercise more. It's I will lose 80 pounds this year. So I'm very specific with the number, with the timeline. I'm really, really detailed with it. And this is going to do a few things for your brain. Firstly, putting it in first person makes it a plan rather than a desire. So saying that I will do this is actually convincing your brain that you're already started and you're already going. So there's no time to actually think of any excuses why you shouldn't. And secondly, since we're being very specific with it, it's telling your brain exactly what you have to do so that your brain doesn't have time to question and really think of what exactly do I have to do. And then you get overwhelmed and then you never do anything because you don't have any idea. So here we're very precise, and that's going to tell your brain, okay, simple, this is what I have to do. Now that we have our goals, step two, create action. Personally, what I like to do is put three actions for each goal to help me actually work towards them every single day. So for this goal of losing 80 pounds, what I'm going to do is do a minimum of 3 HIIT workouts per week, no carbs after 6 p.m., and I'm going to drink 4 liters of water every day. So now that we created this plan of action and actual initiative, that means that your goal is now active. It's no longer something passive in the back. It's no longer just a desire. You really have something that you're striving towards. Also, just a little side note, I want to know if any of you have actually tried this technique before where you actually create action behind each goal. If you have, please comment it down below and let me know in the comment section. That'd be really cool. Step three, micro goals. Now, this is something that's really important because looking at a big goal like losing 80 pounds is something that's going to take quite some time. And I don't know if I'm actually going to be able to stay committed for that long. So what can we do? Well, the first thing that I like to ask is, what can I do this week or what can I do this month, depending on how much energy the task takes? So let's look at it as this week. I think that I could lose 3 pounds this week. So I'm going to write a micro goal of lose 3 pounds this week. And what can I do this week right now to actually make sure that I'm on track to hit that goal? See, accountability is something a lot of people forget. What you could do is tell a friend or even tell them that if you don't hit this goal, then you're going to give them 5, 10 bucks, whatever is good for you. But you're putting something on the line, which is going to push you to do it. In this case, since I know myself well enough to know that my discipline is there, I'm going to make sure that I'm active about it by checking my weight every morning. And that way, every morning I see whether I had progress or if I slipped up the day before. Step four, prioritization. This part is one that kept me from hitting my goals for a very, very long time. See, I'd start off super motivated, and over time, I would just lose the drive. I just wouldn't want to do it anymore. So what can I change in my life right now to actually make sure that I prioritize these goals, that I'm actually chasing them and I'm active about them? Well, I can review them every time I wake up or right before I go to bed. I can add them to my calendar so I get a notification on my phone throughout the day when I have to act on it. I can even put notes around my house, like let's say next to my gaming setup or anything, where if ever I'm procrastinating, I can get a little reminder like, hey, you should be doing this. Those are things that work for me, but you guys can experiment. And if you have any suggestions, comment it down below, help each other out. Another bonus tip is to create an accountability group. This is essentially a group with people that have similar goals or people that are striving to accomplish something, and you guys can hold each other accountable and push each other to get better and to achieve those goals. This doesn't have to be people you know in real life. This could be on social media or this could be on Discord, which actually I'm going to leave a link down in the description to my Discord. And if you guys want to join that, we can set one up over there as well. With all that being said, I do really, really, really want to help you guys achieve these goals. So if you have any questions or anything, please reach out to me on social media or in the comments, and I'm going to be answering everybody. So if you found the advice in this video helpful, then please share it with a friend. Maybe it's going to help them out as well. And on that note, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys next week. Peace.